Welcome back to my backyard snack yard. September is here, and with it, apple season is upon us. All the apples are ripening so beautifully, and we have been picking them constantly for lots and lots of snacks. But today, because it's the very last day before school starts again, I want to make a special apple and cinnamon snack with my sourdough. I love sourdough. And so I thought I'd pick a bowl of apples for that. The apples I want to use are actually some cookers. Oh, look at some of these though. They're looking so beautiful. They come right off. It's amazing. They're so tasty and gorgeous. But yeah, the cookers are over here. They're on our largest apple tree. Let's just have a look over here. So they have a bit of a tartness to them, which I really like. And they're just a little bit too tart to eat, people think, like straight, you know, off the tree. But they're just so good for using in cookery and baking. And the first year I actually made loads of apple jelly, which was delicious too. But let's just pick a bunch of these now. These ones are so delicious. When we first moved here, they were super tiny, but we've done lots of pruning and they are just so big and juicy and tasty. They've got some acidity in them. They're really, really beautiful, well-balanced apples. So there we go, got enough now, definitely, for my little baking treat. Look how lovely and red the insides of the apple are. Oh, this is a beautiful red one. This is actually an idea I got after tasting one of these cinnamon swirls at a National Trust property. And they had cut little tiny pieces of apple in between, and it made it taste almost like an apple pie, just like really autumnal flavors with all the cinnamon and the brown sugar and the apples, of course. So, oh, I really want to recreate that right now. I'm going to cut these apples into tiny pieces. This is how small the pieces were in the little apple cinnamon swirls we had. I actually wonder if we'd better to grate them, but we've done it now, so let's get on with making the filling. I already made the beautiful dough yesterday because it is sourdough, so it takes a while to rise. So here they are, these beautiful cinnamon swirls with lots of little apple pieces poking out. They're going to taste so good, I know it. But now they need to sit and wait for 2 hours because with sourdough, you always need to wait. It needs to ferment and sit and rise and everything. So in 2 hours, we can pop them into the oven. It's always worth the wait. So here they are, fresh from the oven after baking for 40 minutes at 175 degrees Celsius. They smell so good. It really has an apple pie scent to them. Can't wait to taste them. I can confirm they definitely tasted a beautiful apple pie. Thank you so much for watching. Please let me know what you love making with apples.